What's up, guys? It's your boy NaveedCentral, and I'm making this mukbang today with a very special guest, my good friend and TikTok superstar with over 200,000 followers on TikTok right now, the Arabian Guy One. How you doing, my brother?
I just got, you're the king at making introductions, man. I swear to God, man. Bro, I don't want to eat. All that's going to shove it in my mouth, fam. Look at that.
Guys, we are Phat Buns today in Birmingham, and literally about to try their absolutely delicious topped Angus burger with mac and cheese in there. They've got turkey bacon, we've got loads, we've got potato tots. I don't know about how it tastes.
What?
Proper thing.
Bro, that is... You can't swear, can you? We can't swear, can we? Can we?
Because we're not, yeah.
That is fucking amazing, man. Oh my God, bro. That cheese is unbelievable.
It's fine, really fine.
Bro. Bro, we need this in Sheffield, man. I swear to God, man. Our food up there is...
Yo, guys, this is actually fire. We got chicken wings, hot dog, potato tots, milkshake, and yeah...
What's that?
Potato tots, you have them?
First time trying in my life, guys. Here we go.
You got any fries?
Bro, what is that? I don't know what it is. It's nice.
It's called potato tots. But, guys, we got Phat Buns in Birmingham. Honestly, guys, I knew it was going to taste good, but I didn't know it tasted good.
This is delicious, man. Sheffield is the most deadest place. Oh, we got more! Yo! What's your name, brother?
What's that? First one is a frozen one drinks.
Oh, thank you, brother.
Yours?
Coke with the Fanta.
Yeah?
It's a strawberry with the blueberry.
Brother. I like my Fanta with no ice. No, I'm joking.
Thank you, Habibi, bro. You, big shout out to you, bro.
Ayaz, I think his name is, yeah?
Yeah, bro. Shout out to
Ayaz,
man.
You know, we'll try both, bro. I'm going to say.
This is heaven.
But yeah, guys. We are super excited today because we're going to move that out of the way though. You can see everything. Right? So yeah, man, Asad. The Arabian Guy One, but his name's Asad, right? Yeah? Well, that's your brand name, isn't it?
Hello, yeah.
So basically, you know, tell us, man, like, move up a little bit, please, bro, just so we can get you in. So how did it all start, man? Because, by the way, we made a video ages back that got blocked, right? And that was about how we met in a company which we can't mention the name of. We got scammed by that company. The video got loads of views on YouTube, but then what happens? They reported it because obviously they were trying to say that we called them a scam, but they were a scam, but we can't say anything about that one now. But anyway, we met like that. Ever since then, you were on, how much followers did you have then? About?
Back then?
Yeah.
About 95, just under, oh, just, no, 100.
100K. Yeah, now you've done 232,000 on TikTok. By the time you're watching this video, if you're watching this later in the year,
hopefully, that's the goal. For both of us, half a million coming soon.
So how did it all begin, Asim, man? How did you get into TikTok?
I'll be brutally honest, yeah. I swear to God. The short answer, you. No, genuinely, yeah? Short answer is you. I remember you telling me, Asad, you know what? I've seen your Instagram stories that you put up your Snapchat. You've got that natural kind of flair. You should just put whatever video you want to do on anything. You told me to put it on YouTube. Yeah. And you even suggested, you said, you know what? Just do Arab skits.
Exactly.
And I thought, you know what? I'll give it a go. So I started posting on YouTube, but I didn't really get that many views. It kind of demotivated me, but I still kept on pushing. Until one time, my sister messaged me. She goes, oh, have you seen this new thing called TikTok? And this was like before, like people used to be like, it was massive in India. I said, you know, I'll give it a go. So I remember I posted one stupid video, very stupid. I slept, I woke up and hit 4,000 views. And let me tell you, bro, when that hit 4,000 views, bro, I was running around the house naked, bro. I was like, oh, I can't believe it. Bro, I was over the freaking moon. And that is what motivated me to keep posting more until I just saw one video hit 500,000. And bro, I was ringing all my family around the world saying, I made it. Bro, I just got super excited. And that's what kind of got me hooked up. But I remember if it wasn't for your suggestion, bro, I said I would be here. So my Habibi right there, God bless you, bro. This is his call as much as mine.
You'd still be here, though. You'd still be thinking
about it. Yeah, true. Because we're boys.
But what happened then, like, you started doing it. Obviously, you started seeing them, and what happened from there, then, like, literally, obviously, now you're being there in brand deals with different places and stuff, you know.
Yeah. So I remember I got a message from Boohoo, man. And it was a message from a lady who said she gets represented by Boohoo, man. She wants to get me in the books. I'm thinking 100% is bullshit. Why would they choose me? Do you know what I mean? Oh, Barry Berger is nice, man. I might get his, I might eat mine and I eat yours. From Boohoo, man, I just thought to myself, yo, this is legit. I looked into it, and that motivated me on another level. They sent me some free clothes. Man, bro, I was telling you, I thought that's it, you know what I mean? Like, I've gone international.
Yeah.
Unbelievable feeling. And again, it just motivated me. And then I started getting messages from people, from different agencies, from wanting this, wanting that, just so that they can feature their product or for me to kind of give them a shout out. And that's what kind of got me into like the world of influencer marketing. It made me realize, you know what? You can actually get paid from doing something you enjoy, putting a smile on people's faces. Exactly. I like how you're doing it, you know what I mean? When you're putting a smile on people's faces, it makes me feel good. And imagine, bro, that could be a job in itself.
Exactly.
And that's passion right there, man. And that, again, that just motivated me more and more just to take it to the next level, man.
You know what? It's the way you've grown, though. Like, I respect that. Like, you've just stayed consistent with it, bro. And, you know, like, obviously, you've done trying to, I don't know, I'm sure you can see it on camera, but I don't know. Let me just make sure, guys, you can see it on camera, because you know it is.
Sometimes you have to check in it.
Oh, no, you can see it. Because sometimes you don't know. The last thing I want is half your beautiful face on the camera, bro. You know what I'm saying? Then again, they do say your left side is better looking than your right.
What do you think?
I think you're perfect on both sides, bro. You know what I'm saying?
When the cameras turn on, I can see, bro.
Okay, let's not go that far. You know, people watching this thing, it's an awkward thing, bro. You know what I'm saying? But
Arabs, bro. Arabs greet each other like that. We kiss on the cheek and wallah, at one point we do the nose touch. But anyway,
irrelevant. The Eskimo kiss.
That's how you call it.
But anyway, what happened to you is, obviously, one thing I wanted to mention was, that's not the only thing you've done, though. you've actually been in Aladdin, right? You've acted in shows,
yeah.
Even as a kid. See what I'm saying, where it all start from?
Yeah.
It's not started from me, essentially, because it started from you being a kid, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, take us back, bro. Take us back to the beginning, right?
Yeah.
How it all started.
So, by the way, that is on another level.
Is it?
Fine. Wallah, bro.
Proper thing.
Try it, bro. Grab a bite. Bro, that bite was bigger than the bite I did. Is that how you're gonna play it, yeah? Watch my bite now. I'm gonna do half of it, watch. What do you think? Nah, isn't it?
Mm.
Yeah. So to answer your question, when I was 12 years old, I was part of a show called Scorpion Island, which was like, I'm a celebrity, get me out of here, but for like kids.
Mm.
So I was the lucky 12 out of hundreds of thousands of applicants that I've auditioned multiple times through numerous rounds.
Yeah.
And I was lucky enough for them to choose me. They liked the way I come across my personality. And I remember I got a letter. How's that, by the way? Nice. Yeah. Well, check him out, by the way.
Yes, what happened?
So, I get a message. They're telling me that congratulations, I'm the lucky 12 to be featured. They're taking us all the way to Australia.
Mm-hmm.
Man, you can only imagine how I felt. I was flat. Wow. From there, we went all the way to Australia for 3 weeks. We saw Anton Deck, met the geezers, and they were actually filming. I'm supposed to get me out of here. For that series.
Did you know at the time or did you just?
No, I didn't know. It was just coincidence. That's where they're filming. And at that moment, it just made me, with Dick and Dom, remember them? Bogies!
Yeah.
If you're using, if you're audience, no. But that's kind of what got me into it. And then it made me think, wow. Now, when my name was on a database, is the volume alright, by the way?
Yeah, my computer,
you know. Okay. Whenever you do something like that, you get put in a database. I get called for a show, and they didn't tell me what it was. Come down to Shepperton Studios in London. We want you to do something. I was like, alright, cool, paid, perfect, a grand. I was like, wow, we can.
Yeah.
Just to go to London, yeah? Next minute, they sit us down. They're like, oh, by the way, guys, we want you to dress up in this type of costume. These are your character roles. And tomorrow we'll let you know what show you're going to do. I was like, alright, cool. Next minute, they tell us, by the way, guys, it's the Aladdin. I'm thinking it's not the Hollywood Aladdin, it's probably like the bootleg.
No, bro,
I thought it was like the bootleg version. Until they actually told us, no, it's the actual thing. Bro, that was on another level. And it was at that moment when we were filming, someone walks in through the door. This is the best bit. Someone walks in through the door, and I'm thinking to myself, I'm closer to the door. I'm thinking, you know what? This guy, he's like 6'2", he's a dark-skinned guy, he's got a good charm on him. I think he looks like Will Smith.
Will Smith, yeah?
Oh shit, that is Will Smith! Bro! He comes past, he goes, how are you guys? You guys alright? How are you guys? You alright? He nudged my shoulder, bro. I was starstruck. I went, yo, my like, Will, what are you saying? I didn't know what to say. And then he was like, yeah, I'm good, guys, I'm good. And then he just goes, yeah, bro, and then he just chimped. After that, I never cleaned my shoulder, but besides that, bro.
You never cleaned your shoulder.
Brain took Will Smith, fam. Anyway, from that, I thought, wow. Like, it just started taking off. And then, like, Lord of the Rings, Tolkien. The dressing up as an Indian character. And the love for performing, being on camera, on TV, and just, you know, that just kind of motivated me to carry on. And I'm hoping that, I'm giving some inside information, only your fans will know, yeah?
Yeah.
Never Back Down. Have you seen the movie?
I haven't seen it, but I've heard of it.
The MMA one.
MMA
one. Never Back Down. You should know, you're an MMA guy.
I know, but I've heard of it.
Yeah,
but
the third one is getting filmed in London, and I'm in there in 2 weeks' time.
Really?
Playing a character, wallah.
That is sick.
Yeah, so I was
like... Like, bigger scene?
It's a bigger scene, but it's a talking scene. I'm just hoping I make the director's cut. But yeah, so bro, it's just that, man, and that's kind of the
that's
way.
That's gonna be sick, man. That's gonna be sick, bro.
Thank you. Sorry, I feel like that was a long answer, man.
With the mukbang, you need long answers. Fire in it. Thank you, fire. The food's actually good. We're not lying.
It's the macaroni and cheese that kills it, bro.
And the macaroni and cheese in there, man. Like, I love mac and cheese, by the way, guys. Before I come here, I said I'm not going to eat much, but we end up ordering so much that we don't really remember how much you ordered, innit?
You think with your eyes, not with your stomach.
Yeah, you know what I mean? But it's cool, but literally, guys, you know, it's crazy how life progresses. Look at that.
Nah, man.
But this thing, even in acting, it's slowly like getting into the... You're going to get bigger and bigger, bro.
Yeah.
Like, it's mad.
Oh, bro. There's one thing that I've learned from all this, yeah?
Yeah.
And you're a living testimony to this, yeah? The moment you stop caring what people think, I swear to God, bro, your life changes. I'm not even exaggerating when I say that. So, as soon as I stop caring what people think, I just did it. They dressed me up as an Indian character. I looked a bit funny in that. They just did it. I was on it, do you know what I mean? And that's when your life changes, bro.
It's crazy, so, when you think about it, bro, like literally. Amazing, I love it. Beautiful, the food is beautiful.
I beg you to come to Sheffield, bro. I'm begging you, bro. What more do you want?
I'll come and talk to you.
Okay, have you?
But guys, honestly, guys, basically, you know, the food is delicious, though. It's fun.
Bang.
I love it, man. Like, I've tasted the wing. You tasted the wing yet? Oh, have a wing, bro. Have a wing.
Have you had it yet?
Nah, I've had a wing. I've had a wing. Can't lie on camera, can I? I've had a wing. Actually fine, taste it. Sweet and sour thing now.
Wow.
Now it's starting to cool down though, but...
Still nice, yeah.
Crispy as well.
Bro, you're going to send me back to Sheffield rolling. Bro, food is banging.
Isn't it?
Wow.
Food is banging though.
Bro. Sometimes you just need to enjoy the food.
Ah, should I put that? You know what? Should I put down? Crispy nuts into the mic. I love that.
Mm-hmm.
But.
What do they call it? ASMR. Something like that, isn't it?
People like that shit?
Yeah, bro. Some people actually watch it.
You know what people actually do? Like, bro, not some. You got millions of views, bro.
Bro, I didn't watch. I saw a video of a fat lady walking on top of a skinny guy, and it was ASMR. And you just hear her like feet bouncing on him.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was weird though. But I'm like, people are into that kind of stuff.
And everyone like everyone different things. You're not wrong. Whatever floats your boat, mate. It's crazy, man. What's the hot dog saying? Hot dog, fine, isn't it? I don't eat too much, man!
Just eat, bro!
I don't know, but I'm meant to be on a diet, but I fucked up today.
Bro, I'm just enjoying this one. Bro, tell your followers, man, they need to come here, bro.
Right. I'm not just saying it. I nearly caned my burger, I wanted to slow down because of him. I said, look at you, done. But you know what them ones, when you're eating your burger, bro, and you're like, yo.
I got some old guys from up north, man. My nephew's
Nice to meet you,
bro. You right, yeah?
Hassan, nice to meet you, bro. Nice to meet you, bro.
Go. This food is fire though. The mac and cheese just kills it.
That's the like winning thing, isn't it?
Mmm. The beef is fire, I don't know.
Yeah, it's quality.
Look at the cheese that.
Smash burgers is the new thing now, isn't it?
It's very good, you know.
I've seen it pop up. Bearing in mind we only have one in Sheffield. But I can imagine Birmingham is even more competitive, isn't it?
Bro, there's so many places that are doing now.
Yeah?
Like, but you know what it is? In a place like this, what on point?
This raises the bar, bro.
It raises the bar.
Other companies need to take a look at. Not Burger Bay, I keep calling it a Burger Bay.
Fat Buns. But it was going to be originally called Burger Bay, that's why we say that.
Yeah.
Isn't it? That's what they
say.
Which is crazy, we were told that. Mmm.
Wow.
Only potato tops. Why are you eating these, bro?
I want to fill my stomach with the good stuff, bro. The protein.
Bro, I swear to God. Guys, look at that. Double.
You know what that means? Good luck. I just fully made it up.
Oh. Guys. You know, like, in school they doesn't crush it, so I record them.
Yeah.
I prefer these to fries, you know.
Yeah, to be honest, I'm not much of a fried person, but that, I can settle with that. Wallah, I can settle with that easily.
It's like Dubai, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's mad guy, like, literally. So yeah, man, like, what's the plans then, bro? What are you doing plans?
Like yourself, bro, we just want to continue doing what it is, you know what I mean? My goal, bro, to be brutally honest with you, yeah? Don't laugh at this.
To be rich and famous!
No, don't laugh at this, yeah? But it's to be, like, on the level where I'd like to sit, be a nominee for a Grammy.
Hosting the motherfucking show.
Bro, you imagine! Bro,
I'm hosting the motherfucking show. He's bringing him on, yo.
No way, this one's going to be. You're going to be like, all right, guys, to nominate the best actor for 2024, yeah? We've got Jack Black. We've got Leonardo DiCaprio, we've got Johnny Depp. Oh, we've got my boy Hassan, what are you saying, Hassan? We got Hassan up in here. I'll be like, yeah, man.
They're talking about it's fake, he's hosting, I mean, he's lying.
Bro.
He's his mate.
Yeah, that's my end goal, to be honest with you. Like, just to be on stage and do, like, the big stuff, like, bro, Avengers, for example. Make me a villain, I don't care, bro. Even if I was just a random guy sat on the corner, That's the goal I want to be, bro. And you know what it is? When you're doing that kind of stuff, you surround yourself with the right people.
Yeah. It starts to happen, it starts to click.
Oh, man.
Oh, look, coincidentally, me and you connected, yeah? Like, even when we were doing in that company, yeah, that we got scammed by, yeah, we can't mention that right now, basically. When we were in that company, we actually clicked, and it's a small world in the sense that we're both en route to a similar journey now. It's mad, like...
It went like this,
innit? It's mad, though, innit? Yeah. When you really think about it. It really is crazy, like, when you really think about it, you sit down and think, hold on one second, that's crazy, but, like, could we be on the same journey?
But we're big believers in everything happens for a reason, right or wrong, yeah?
I agree with that.
We have same, like, kind of personality. I think you're a bit more crazy than me, though. I'll give you that.
No, I think... I haven't got enough buttons, that's the only thing. Like, I have got enough buttons, but not as much as you have, you're a bit more sane than me.
Yeah, you're more insane.
But we can be... as crazy as each other, it's just...
But in the same room, it'll be a disaster for,
for people. If me and him went into a room being told, you gotta fuck shit up, yeah? Let me tell you, then...
Hashtag Madrid, hashtag Boston.
Hashtag Madrid, yeah? Then it's a different story, because then it's both on button. If both of our on buttons are on, that's it.
No one's gonna turn it off.
They're not turning it off. It's true though, isn't it? Really truly, bro.
Bro. Yeah, man. Honestly, it's just crazy because we have the same goals, we have the same aspiration. We have the same personality and stuff, so it's only natural that we kind of come together because between us is a mutual friend.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Now you're not as close to him anymore as you're with me.
It's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah,
even though he's a good friend, still a good friend. Oh, yeah, and I haven't really seen him much, you know. But it's like we've come closer than many men.
No, it's true.
That'd be awkward if he's watching. Like,
you went to uni with the guy as well. Yeah. And obviously he did the boxing with you. But nah, it's just crazy because now we're on the same goal. And it just goes to show that personalities attract. You know what I mean?
It's crazy.
Wallah.
It's like everything happens for a reason. You meet people for a reason. I met for a reason. Guys, I'm actually going to do this right now. And you're going to hear this. You're going to hear the crispiness, yeah?
Don't get them. See how I like it. I'm gonna do one with a sausage, yeah? That sounds wrong, fam.
That sounds wrong.
Alright, here we go.
That sounds wrong. Wow.
Feels weird when I do that.
Huh?
Feels weird when I do that.
And the mic.
Yeah.
You're thinking,
why am I going this way? David, well, like, you know what? I'm starting to get full.
I'm kind of full now. I'm saying.
What if I can eat that, bro?
Oh, bro. Mm.
Thank God for the food, man.
Mm. Good. Who's
that? But you know what? Would you say you've got supportive family that support you with what you're doing?
Yes or no?
No, I'm interviewing you, bro. Go on.
Yes or no?
Go on, why?
Yes or no?
Mix.
As time's gone on, more people are accepting it now.
Mm.
Initially, it depended. Mainly with the kids who respected, man. You get me? But a lot of people probably still do try and laugh behind my back. Or, I mean, making these videos, like, oh, what is he doing?
Yeah.
You're gonna see, motherfucker, what we're doing. You get me when we're out there? And honestly, I'm out here to help my family, you know what I'm saying? That's why we do this, man. That's why we do this.
Again,
help our families, you get me? Like, yo, our families have tried their best their whole lives. We can give back to them. And then watching this right now, people say, I want to be average. What, you can give back to your family?
So, no, it's true. It goes back to that thing, that common goal. You want to help your family. Same.
Yes,
and also, the biggest thing, you don't care what people think. You don't care what people think. You want to help your family. These two are the main sort of ingredients to just smashing it, bro. I mean,
it's crazy.
Honestly, bro, I look at you and the rate that you're going to, bro.
Now, martial arts, slowly I'm going, slowly.
I'm on a level, bro. Well, I'm not just saying this. Yeah, cameras are there, bro. You are genuinely smashing it, bro. And
I'm martial arts, slowly, but surely you're getting it. But like, we're trying and look at, bro. You know how much shit I'm busy with that, bro.
Oh, man. Yeah, 100%.
The man of grind you put into that company, bro. Can't even go there, but you know what I'm saying?
And all it takes is for one thing to break free, like, for you. Do you know what I mean? That's the beauty about it. You know what, bro? The rate that we're going at, trust me, man, inshallah. The more you do, you'll hit that one that will open you up. And the beauty thing about it is that if I'm blowing up, bro, best believe you, I'm going to get my voice. No, I'm being serious, bro, because at the end of the day, if I'm eating, I want it. People on my team to eat as well. Do you get what I mean?
But it's sick, though, because if you make it, and you make it together, one thing I've learned about success is, isn't it? But as you're getting bigger, you're getting people messaging you who you don't even know that well.
Mm.
And these people probably didn't necessarily support you before.
Exactly.
They probably all those were laughing at you. So if you got people, and this is the truth, I will say this bluntly, right? When you become successful, you don't want to be chilling with people who ain't on the same common cause, because they're going to bring you down, right? If certain people are, you know, they don't want to get nowhere in life and all they want to do is party all the time, right? You know, like, no, some people party and they still got a good common, like, cause and they got big dreams. Okay, cool. They're still on route, right? What I mean is people
majority,
who literally just party and do no big dreams, nothing. I just want to see, like, you can't have the people around you.
Yeah.
You got to limit yourself from them people.
That's it.
But the thing about it is, when you become successful, you don't know if these people would have been your friend had you not been famous.
It's true.
Right?
That's the only issue, isn't
so
it?
So to have people who are famous, but you knew beforehand, is a million times better, because you know you can trust them.
You know they're genuine.
Yeah, because they knew you before you're famous.
Yeah.
But it's not like they're going to use you now, because you're on the same level. You're making the same amount of money, you've got the same fame. But then you know them in and out.
See, that's what worries me about the future, because sometimes as well, like, even like when I get in a relationship, I'm single, yeah? But would I know, for example, inshallah, you know, with the grace of God, hopefully, I will be successful and I'll help my family and everyone, yeah? But you don't know whether the person that's in your life is in it for that or that. That's just one thing. But yeah, the people that are currently in there.
Yeah. You know what I mean? It's a tough one, isn't it?
But I agree with you 100%. And like I said, it's a good thing knowing that, you know, when you make it, you're up there. You've got someone that's on your level, start from zero with you.
Exactly, bro. Oh, like, can you imagine me and you are both famous.
Yeah.
We're in a place where we're like, yo.
Yeah.
We've smashed it.
Yeah.
And then we're able to chill, bro. And we're speaking about times when we never had much or whatever.
Do you remember we were in the Mukbang underneath the Burger Bay sign?
But I was listening to a guy here, Andy Fasilla, is sick, yeah? Basically, he speaks about, he says, yo, sometimes them were the best memories. He goes, you know when you were en route to success?
Yeah.
He goes, that's when, like, you gotta enjoy the journey. You gotta enjoy the journey, yes. Because, like, okay, look, memories like this. You're telling me, listen, when we're gonna be fully famous, like, I mean, like, multi-fucking millionaire famous, inshallah, yeah, we retired our family, everything, yeah? You know, living our dream lives, inshallah, inspiring millions of people around the world. Will we really be able to sit inside a place like this? We can't, because, you know, everyone just...
You'll get people coming up to you.
People like, you know, people probably gonna attack you.
Need bodyguards left, right.
You need bodyguards, you need people with you, bro. Literally, that's how life's probably gonna be, innit?
Yeah, yeah.
But like, this kind of shit is memories, and this is something that is a part of the journey.
Yeah,
and that's why I always believe in fucking embracing the journey, man.
Bro, you stole what I was gonna say. A wise man once told me, don't enjoy the result, enjoy the journey. And it's true, bro, because when you enjoy the journey, memories are built and you've got something to base it back on. Do you get what I mean? Oh, bro, yeah.
Because once you're going to reach there...
Oh, yeah.
You've reached there now.
Yeah. But then again, you might have reached there, but then you still want to reach there, so you think you're still on a journey, bro. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
As long as you've got goals,
you're
always on a journey.
Yeah.
I don't think you should ever have a final point.
What?
How boring would it be to have a final point? Have you ever had a day where you're doing absolutely fuck all?
Yeah.
At the end of the day, don't you feel like I've done fuck all today?
You feel shit. You feel like I need to do more for tomorrow. Yeah.
And I think that, like, even if it's learning something in it, what do you think, like...
Anything, bro. I feel like you need to have a day where you keep doing something. This is for me, so obviously everyone's different, yeah? But I don't want to waste a day.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Same here, bro.
Yeah, you know, I can feel the energy, bro.
If I have kids and stuff in the future...
Inshallah.
I think... Just chilling with your kids might be amazing.
Yeah.
But imagine being with your kids and teaching them something on a daily basis.
Definitely.
Like, that's something that you look forward to.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, instead of being like, grab me the Cheetos. You know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean? Like,
see, that's why it's important. It all comes down to this, yeah? You're going through the journey, but also is the people that you surround yourself with. I swear to God, bro, I'm a big believer in that. So obviously, like, when you have a kid, you obviously you're gonna be with your missus, and you've gotta make sure your missus is supportive, is like you, is not a chiller, likes to grind, likes to grow together. Do you know what I mean? So it all matters about the people you surround yourself with. And if it ain't good, bro, cut it away. Obviously, you do that anyway. But that's one advice I'd say to your audience, bro. Honestly, do what makes you happy. Don't care what people think. And surround yourself with the right people and just go for it. Honestly, there's no hidden paths or anything like that. That's what you have to do. And once you knock them each one by one, that's it. I swear, you will realize, you look back, you think, bloody hell, I've done a lot of shit. I've got so much things I've done. This is good content, and you stand out.
Exactly, honestly, exactly, bro. Exactly. You know what? I fully agree with you, bro. Like, I just can't imagine where you're going to be in the next few months, inshallah, man. You're going to smash it, bro. Like, inshallah, you are going to be in that movie, and that's going to add to your portfolio,
that's,
bro. Like,
that's what I'm looking at it as. Do you know what I mean? And again, it all comes down to having that one break. Do you know what I mean? You miss every chance you don't take, right? All it takes is to get lucky once. Do you know what I mean? And the more harder you work, the luckier you get.
Yeah.
It's that simple, bro.
Because some people do get lucky. Like people say, no. Okay, it's destiny, but what it is, what I mean is, people do get lucky. There's some people who will probably do the exact... I'll give an example, right?
Yeah.
Sometimes you see videos of things that you've done, but what you did didn't go viral. Someone else has done something.
Yeah.
And then you see that and you think, hold on 1 second, I did that same video?
Yeah.
It does happen, doesn't it?
Of course. But then...
That's where I think luck does play a part for people.
Yeah.
But you got to keep grinding.
Because when that luck comes to you, you've got someone to help you. Yeah.
Because you don't want to be in a position where you're... See, you want a documentation, you want documents... Like either how fast you go. Why you go so far? You come so fast.
30.
Hello, hello.
Yeah.
Imagine before that, he was, obviously that was just natural. But imagine before that, he'd had so many comedy videos and documents there.
He'd still be relevant today.
Or even the guy who recorded him.
Yeah.
Imagine
yeah.
he had so much content
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
That video would have blown everything, and everything else would have blown to be relevant today.
Like, what's he call it? The thing goes skrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr that's the example of having something behind you that people can still kind of catch up on. Oh, look, he's the one that did this. Oh, look at that. It opens them to a world where, oh, they can see all the other comedies he's done. Now, 100%, man. But again, the harder you work, the luckier you get.
Exactly, man. Now, you know what, bro?
Bro, one night, I'm so happy I see this guy. Honestly,
I'm happy to see him as well, bro. But what I'm going to say is, bro, I want you to give a massive, you know, inspirational message, man. This is like your Oscar speech here, like, yo.
Shit.
Like, man, I'm awarding you right now, like, yo, you've just smashed it, right, yeah?
Okay.
You've reached the pinnacle of your dreams, right?
Yeah.
You know, and I'm giving you an opportunity to give a speech, right? And
no pressure, man.
In that speech, I want you to give information to those who can, like a blueprint to follow your journey, in essentially.
Okay. I'm just gonna go for it, yeah? Whatever comes out, okay. It might require a lot of editing here, but... So, I'd say there's three factors, yeah?
Let's do this!
You want me to hold this, yeah? this becomes official now, right? I've got the mic.
It feels good.
I'm not even holding it right. I feel like I'm not.
Feels
okay.
Feels good.
Yeah, so there's three main things, yeah?
That's like a sweet and sour, though.
Oh, shit. I already started off well.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Is that right, yeah?
Yeah, cool.
Three main things, okay? I'd say the first one is negativity. Now, Naveed, again, you're a living testimony to this. In life, you're going to get a lot of negativity. A lot of people are going to be telling you, you can't do this, you can't do that. They'll be saying, oh, you shouldn't be doing it, you should be doing it this way. Or the truth of the matter is that no one wants to see you do better. They want to see you at that level or lower. The moment that you start to drift up or do something better, they get negative, and it's kind of like natural for them to do so. So don't let that affect you. Literally let it go from one ear and come out the other, because the moment that you start letting a negativity affect you, it's gonna F up so much plans that you have in the future. So negativity, literally, I'd say get it in and get it out, because on your way to success, you're gonna face a lot of that. That's number one. Number two is rejection. Now, you're going to face a lot of rejections in life on your way to success. Not just in work. It could be in anything. Even a relationship, for God's sake. You know, you might get rejected by a girl or a guy if you're, you know, in a relationship, anything like that. But
I've experienced that many times before.
No, we all have. But the thing is, you should always remember this. Like, every single no gets you closer to yes. On a level. So embrace it. When you hear that no, no problems. Keep going. Because I promise you, the moment that the next no goes past, the moment that you hear that yes, you think, oh my God, that has been worth it. And I always like to say this example of J.K. Rowling. She's gone to like, what, tens and twenties of different book publishing companies. She's gone to so many of them. Every single one of them said no. But I think it was like the 26th one or 27th, they actually turned around and said, yeah, we'll give it a shot. And because of that, it became what it is now, Harry Potter. Imagine, Naveed, she actually stopped. So rejection, embrace that shit and keep going for it. And the third, but finally, not the least, is consistency. Be consistent. Keep at it. The best athletes, the best celebrities, the best legends I've lived in our lifetime have always been consistent in one thing. Ronaldo, as an example, he'd kick a football on the wall hours, just doing the same thing, just being consistent until he's perfected his touch. So many different examples. Just be consistent and have it programmed in your head. Remember, this thing in here can change everything, can give you the life of your dreams. But it's all a matter of getting these three factors, putting it in your head, and fixing your mind. And I'd say that's the main thing, because this thing right there that God's given us, man, it's a powerful thing. Make sure you use it well and don't let it get put to waste, man. And think of your family. Boom.
Yo, that was sick. I love that. That was inspiration. That fired me up, you know what I'm saying?
Let's go make some money.
Let's go do this. But guys, you know, it's been emotional. It's been amazing. It's been incredible, you know, to have my brother, you know, I was going to say Asad, but I'll say the Arabian. His name's Asad Kareem, obviously, and the movie's going to be the rest of it.
Asad Kareem.
But obviously, it's the Arabian guy at the same time. So I don't know. How would I tag you, man? It's both and it's mad.
Tell me the Arabian guy. That's just Arabian guy. I said Kareem. I don't know, yeah.
We're both in it. You got both.
Both, dude.
We can do both, bro. We'll do both.
Thank you, Habib.
But yeah, guys, you know, it's been emotional. It's been amazing. And you know what? I am happy to see how far you're going to go, but also to have you here today.
Thank you, Habib.
And I'm excited. Not just happy, I'm excited to see how far you... No, I know, bro, you can go far, inshallah.
Thank you, Habib.
And
thank
let's
you.
Do this, man. I'm not going to see you at the top. I'm going to see you over the top.
Bro, that was yours that you did, didn't it? Was that your quote that you actually did?
I said that once.
Yeah, I remember.
Why don't I heard it somewhere? I said it myself.
I remember you said it. It went viral. I can't remember.
Listen.
Man, appreciate having me. Thank you so much, man.
You know what we're going to say? NaveedCentral. Make sure you like, comment, and share. Dun, 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 dun. Phat Buns, check them out. Make sure, guys, you know you can tell the food was fire.
Take
Thank you very much.
Peace.
Thank you, bro.